Hello, everyone. You might think these ferrite rings are only good for their normal function, and a simple spark plug is just for engines, but I'll show you how to give them a completely new purpose, capable of some truly surprising feats of DIY engineering. I'm starting with two ferrite rings. They appear a bit grimy, so my first step is to clean them thoroughly. I'll place them in a small bowl and generously spray them with WD-40. This helps loosen any dirt, rust, or residue that has accumulated over time, ensuring a clean surface for our next steps. I'll take a toothbrush and scrub away all the loosened grime. It's important to get into every crevice to ensure the ferrite material is completely clean. A clean surface is crucial for optimal electrical conductivity and efficient coil winding later on. After a good scrub, I'll dry them off completely with a soft cloth. Leave a comment and let me know which country you are watching from. It's great that we can connect and chat from all over the world. Next, I'm taking a length of copper wire. The insulation needs to be removed from the ends for proper connections, so I'll sand those sections until the shiny copper is exposed. I'll carefully begin winding the copper wire around one of the ferrite rings. This creates an electromagnetic coil, which is fundamental to how our new tool will function, as it will generate an alternating magnetic field when current passes through. With the first coil complete, I'll move on to the second ferrite ring. For this one, I'm using a blue insulated wire. Just like before, I'll meticulously wrap this wire around the second ferrite ring, creating another coil. This dual coil setup is designed to enhance the magnetic field and induction, making our device more powerful. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any interesting ideas coming soon. Now that both coils are ready, I'm attaching them to a sturdy wooden base. I'll use a hot glue gun to firmly secure each coil in place. This provides stability for the entire assembly, preventing any movement that could disrupt the delicate wiring or reduce the efficiency of the magnetic field interaction. With the coil secured, it's time to connect the power source. I'm taking a standard electrical plug with its wires. I will connect the wires from the plug to the blue ends and the copper wire wrapped around the magnet, carefully twisting them together to ensure good electrical contact. I will use electrical tape to insulate these connections. Now, let's prepare the heating element. I'm starting with a spark plug. Next, I disassemble a small electrical terminal block to extract these brass connector pieces. These will serve as our primary contact points. So I attach them securely to the spark plug using their tiny screws. This ensures a robust electrical connection. For the actual heating element, I'm going to use a carbon rod extracted from an old battery. Carbon is an excellent choice for this due to its electrical conductivity and its ability to generate significant heat when current passes through it. I'll carefully cut open the battery and retrieve the carbon rod from inside. Once I have the carbon rod, I'll clean it thoroughly. I then mount the carbon rod into my drill and use sandpaper to meticulously sharpen one end to a fine point. This sharp tip will allow for precise heat concentration, which is essential for accurate work. Now, I simply insert the sharpened carbon rod into the brass terminal on our spark plug assembly. It fits snugly, ensuring excellent electrical contact and efficient heat transfer. Then, I'll take a red wire and firmly attach one end to the top of the spark plug assembly. I'm using red electrical tape to insulate and reinforce this connection, ensuring safety and efficiency. With the other end of the red wire, I stripped off the insulation to expose the copper core inside. Then I connected the red wire to the remaining copper wire on the ferrite core and secured it firmly. Now our circuit is almost complete, ready to generate intense heat. With all the connections made, I'm plugging the main power cord into a wall outlet. This will supply the alternating current to our coil setup, creating the strong electromagnetic field needed to heat our carbon rod. I'll add a large alligator clip to make a handle for the soldering iron. I placed two razor blades on the block of wood and began soldering. When I touched the soldering iron to the two metal blades, it heated up instantly. Watch closely. See those sparks and how quickly the metal heats up and starts to glow and melt? This homemade induction heater is incredibly effective at cutting and shaping metal with precision. Our amazing new tool, transforming simple components into a powerful metal melting device. You can even use it to write on metal surfaces, just like I'm doing here, spelling out like. This DIY project proves that with a little creativity and understanding of basic principles, you can achieve fantastic results. If you find the video interesting, please give me a like. Don't forget to share it with your family and friends. Remember to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for your support. Bye.